Hi there, thanks for tuning in. My name is Chris Groves. I am a certified personal trainer, a sports nutritionist, and a lifestyle consultant. My personal mission is to change people's lifestyles through healthy cooking, resistance training, cardiovascular, and quick and easy tips that make their life easier and more efficient and healthier. Each week, we'll be meeting up with new clients who have different goals in life and different challenges through their lifestyle. My job is to tailor a program specific to their needs and their goals. All right, we're here with Joe and Renee, and I am here to help them become healthier through their eating habits and resistance training. All right, Joe and Renee, tell me a little bit about your current lifestyle right now and as far as your troubles you're having.
Okay, we have two busy kids. They're involved in sports, so getting up in the morning and getting them a good, healthy breakfast is difficult for us. We do a lot of frozen breakfasts or packaged cereals, and trying to make healthy meals that the kids will like as well as for Joe and I to like is really difficult.
Okay.
Another challenge is like when we come home, we have a very short time frame between homework with the kids and getting them ready for bed to get something together for dinner. So I'm usually off to the side doing the homework portion, and Renee is trying to get something ready for dinner. So we could use some suggestions in that area as well.
Okay,
so this busy schedule usually leads us to where we have to do fast food or prepackaged dinners, which we know aren't healthy.
Got it.
It makes it difficult for us to achieve our fitness goals as well. So.
And what's your fitness goal?
Add some muscle, tone down a little bit, increase strength.
All right, and then Renee, what are your fitness goals?
My fitness goals is drop some inches around my waist and
can't get
my
any
hips.
Shorter.
Oh. Whoa. Awesome. I think the biggest trouble with anyone's lifestyle changes is making sure they have a plan of attack. So what I'm going to do today is we're going to go over breakfast, lunch, and dinner. That's going to be healthy, really easy for you and the kids to enjoy and to do it again. Okay, so we did a home raid on Renee's and Joe's cabinets. And we found, you know, some good food, some good snacking, some Ho-Hos, some Girl Scout cookies, some high fat hot dogs, and more cookies. All right, so a lot of households have tons and tons of sweets and snacks the kids are gonna be grabbing, and so are the parents. All right, the biggest thing we wanna look at is the fat and carbohydrate ratios every time you're eating something, okay? So let's take the Ho-Ho here. 17 grams of fat per serving, 54 grams of carbohydrates, and 42 sugars. All right, I'm going to tell you what this is going to do. It's going to spike up your blood sugar, and it's going to put it down through the ground. So you're going to have a big energy boost, and then you're going to have a really low low. All right, this is probably not the best selection. I think we can come up with something a little healthier, a little bit more nutritious for a snack to come by. Now, Joe, he wants to pump up the muscles, like he was telling me about before, get some big guns. The protein is key. All right, now this would be the worst protein to have. All right, the ballpark franks, a whopping 16 grams of fat. All right, and 7 grams of saturated fat, the worst fat you can eat. All right, so there is some protein in here, a whopping 6 grams. For Joe's body type, he should be consuming about 220 grams of solid protein to be enhancing his muscle definition and developmentation. Now, when you're looking at fat on a food item, you always want to do a ratio to the protein. In this case, 16 grams of fat to 6 grams of protein is horrible. Usually you want at least double the protein for fat. So if there's 16 grams of fat, there should be about almost 40 grams of protein in this. And that's really too high in the spectrum. You should never go more than 9 grams of fat per serving of any protein.
So what do you suggest?
Chicken breast, turkey, really lean beef, buffalo. There's a lot of different alternatives. Okay, everyone picks up these things because they're easy. You pop in the microwave, you nuke them out, and then you got yourself a quick fatty snack. So I'm gonna come up with a little better selections for you to get a more nutritious, balanced meal with higher protein to build up those guns you want so bad, right?
You're not going to make me cut out the beer, are you?
Every man loves their beer, but everything's about moderation in life. So I'm not going to make you cut out a lot of things. It's just about making sure it coincides with your calories that you need to intake every day. All right, so we're going to make sure you have a little bit of fun in your life too, but in moderation, right?
Awesome.
Okay, so Joe and Renee's biggest challenge is time, like everyone else in the U.S. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to make a whole oatmeal and cottage cheese pancake with a blueberry and Greek yogurt compote to start us off with. All right, so for our oatmeal pancakes with cottage cheese, it has egg whites, a little bit of vanilla, and of course, the star oatmeal. All right, what's awesome about these, we're gonna put about a half cup of oatmeal to start us off with. What's cool about these, it's a slow digestive carbohydrate. Oatmeal is the best. It's gonna get your energy levels up throughout the day, but it's gonna burn slowly, so it's not gonna spike up your blood sugar levels. It's gonna level out through the whole day. And the cool thing about the cottage cheese, it's gonna give a really nice texture, but it's not gonna add, you know, a whole bunch of fat from putting heavy milk in there and sugar. It's gonna be a nice little switch up. And I like to use pineapple cottage cheese because it can give a little sweet flavor to it. Kids like it a lot more. They're not gonna tell that it's totally health food. All right, next thing we're gonna throw in there, we're gonna do about 4 egg whites. Egg whites are awesome, of course, because it can be solid protein without all that negative energy from that yolk, which contains most of your cholesterol and fat. So all we're gonna do, we're gonna put a little touch of vanilla, about a teaspoon. Beautiful. And then a little bit of cinnamon, just for a little flavor. And that's it. And pop the cap on. Little blend. They're all blasted up. We're just gonna turn on the heat. We wanna be about mid-high right here. Get that getting toasty warm. While that's getting heated up, we're gonna make the sauce, all right? This is super simple. We're gonna start off with is blueberries, okay? Now the cool thing about blueberries is they're super antioxidant, all right? They're gonna give you great vitamins, great minerals, and kids love them, and so do us adults. All right, so we're just gonna smash them up. We're gonna get that natural sugars flowing. All right, let's get a good smash. And we do this to get the sugar out of the picture, all right? So it's gonna get good flavor without adding all that extra sugar to spike up all that blood sugar. Now what I just put in there is a Greek yogurt. The cool thing about Greek yogurt is it's super high in protein. This one actually has no fat and 2 grams of carbohydrates, 22 grams of protein per full cup, all right? We're only gonna use a 1/4 cup in here because the pancake's already loaded with protein, but it's gonna be a really nice texture to it and a great flavor. All right, now the pan's nice and hot, we're gonna start making our pancakes. All right, so we wanna test the first one. This person's always a tester. We're just gonna put on about 3-4 inches in diameter. Let it set, all right? We're only gonna start with one. Three per serving, that's almost gonna be about 30 grams of protein. Just gonna put a little bit of that sauce on top, layer it over. This takes the place of that sugary syrup that everyone loves to put on it. Like I said, it's gonna be a healthy alternative. No fat, 30 grams of protein and only about 15 grams of carbohydrates. So it's gonna be a really nutritious, simple meal that I think the kids will love, and so will your parents. But it's gonna be a lot more nutritious, and they're pretty simple. You can keep these up in your fridge for about a week if you wanna make a bigger batch and make them throughout the try. So they just had the oatmeal, egg white pancakes with the blueberry and Greek yogurt compote. It, like I said, it's a very quick and efficient way to get your breakfast done, get the kids happy, keep your parents happy. And if you want to make a bigger batch for the week, so you just keep it in the fridge and then put it out every morning, it takes about 5 minutes and you're getting a nutritious, healthy breakfast that's going to start your day off right.
The plate speaks for itself. They're gone. They're awesome. And they're quick. So that's something I can make for breakfast every morning.
All right, well, they just enjoyed a healthy, nutritious breakfast. Now we're coming around to lunchtime, right? Around 12, 1 o'clock, we want something really nutritious and it hits the spot and keeps our energy levels up for the rest of the day.